I started to get interested in data visualization when I started teaching data analytics and accounting in our accounting program. And employers were really interested in getting new hires that knew how to create good data visualizations, also use visualization to analyze large sets of data. So to teach it, I had to be able to really understand some of the best practices. So I started researching it, I started going to seminars, and you know, just worked at improving my skills in it so that I could then relay that to my students. I think that probably the most interesting data visualization gone wrong story that I heard, or maybe the funniest one that I heard, was another colleague was including data visualizations in an exam, and she thought that she had created like this great visualization for the students to be able to analyze, and completely didn't realize that she used colors that people that were colorblind couldn't see. So she had several students that came up to her and they're like, I don't see anything in this visualization. So I tell that story when I do presentations on best practices, because even though I think only 8% of the population actually is colorblind, you still have to keep that in mind. One of the reasons we've seen data visualization increase so much being used in business is because there's so much data. And it's hard to make sense of the data often by just looking at the numbers. So using data visualization, you can quickly understand really large sets of data. And that helps you to get a better understanding of what's happening within your business, within your organization, whatever it is that you're analyzing. So in that respect, it's helped to make very quick decisions because you don't have to spend hours analyzing the numbers. You can just visualize the data. Yeah, I conduct behavioral research, and I chose that type of research because how people make decisions fascinates me. So a lot of my research is in decision making and how people use business data to make decisions. I've also done some research in incentives, and one of the most interesting results that we found, and it's actually in an article that the IMA published in their Management Accounting Quarterly Journal, was an incentive study where we were testing to see if people would work harder for money or for something non-monetary. And instinctively, we all say we want money. And in fact, when we ask the participants which type of compensation they prefer, do they prefer cash or a non-monetary but tangible? So maybe a gift card, maybe coffee, maybe in a business situation, you know, Fridays you can wear jeans. And we found that even though the participants told us they wanted the cash, they actually worked harder for the tangible non-monetary benefit. And if you added intangible to that, so you added recognition to that, then they worked even harder. So I thought that was fascinating, because even what they told us they wanted, they actually ended up performing differently than what they said they would. A good data visualization is one that gets the point across that you're looking to get across, using the least amount of space on the page, and creates a sense of understanding that can then lead to a decision. So it sounds like it's pretty simple, but narrowing down to the exact data and information that you need to translate to the person looking at the visualization, that's the hard part. Research has shown that we remember stories, right? We can relate to stories. It makes the experience memorable for us. If you think back to even when you first started, you know, when you were a baby, we read stories to children, right? You read stories to learn the language. You read stories to understand a situation. And so telling a story with your data when you're trying to get across the analysis that you've done is really important, so that you can bring the reader along with you. So if you tell a story, you keep their interest, and you're able to move them through what would be a lot of complex data and potentially complex visualizations to one cohesive story. So it's an important aspect of data visualization. One of the things you have to really think about when you're preparing your visualizations for your presentation, for whatever it is, whether you're presenting to a coworker, a boss, the C-suite, you know, you have to really think about who the audience is going to be and make sure that they can understand the visualizations that are there. So you have to kind of ride that line of not making it overly difficult if, you know, your audience doesn't really understand all the details. On the other side, you don't want to make it so simple that the people you're presenting to feel, you know, maybe even insulted that you haven't been, that you assume that they don't understand the level that you have. It's more impactful if you really, really are presenting to the audience that's going to be there to understand what they know. So you know how much detail to put in and how much detail to leave out. Ethics and visualizations, I think, are really related because we see so many visualizations in the real world, everyday life. You see visualizations online, you see them on TV, you see them in news media, magazines, all trying to tell a story. And if we don't really think about what that visualization is telling us and really think critically about how accurate it is, we can be really misled by the information. So I think it's important when you're preparing visualizations that the preparer keeps that in mind. You shouldn't be putting together a visualization that deliberately influences someone to think in a certain way that isn't true for the data. So one of the examples that I use is sometimes we'll see a visualization where they don't start the scale at zero. So if you start it at, you know, if you have a variety of data, say your data points go from 45 to 60, but you start the axis at 40, it looks much more dramatic, your increase from 40 to 60, than if you start it from zero and go to 100. So you are either inadvertently or maybe deliberately making the viewer see the visualization as more significant than what it really is. And I think that's a big issue. I think it's an issue in, you know, in what we see in public media, and I think it's an issue in what we see people do in organizations as well. One of the things that I have been really passionate about over the last 5 years is how important it is that accountants embrace things like data visualization, tools to do it, and the responsibility for performing analyses using it. If the accounting profession doesn't step up and kind of join this change, technology change that's been happening, whether it's the analytics piece or the visualization piece, I don't think we remain relevant as a profession. And I think that we're in a great position. We already know how to do the analyses. We understand the data. We understand the story. We just have to get better at telling it. And I think once we do that, I think we become an even more valued business partner.